Hello friends, subscribe to our channel GDC and press the bell icon for more updates.
Students, welcome to the channel. So today in this video, we are going to discuss some questions with their brief explanation. So here we have first question is, which of the following is the examples of apimers? So options are, option A, glucose and galactose, option B, glucose and ribose, option C, sucrose and glucose, option D, fructose and glucose. So which of the following is an example of apimers? So the correct answer is glucose and galactose are the examples of apimers. So let's discuss with the help of explanation part that in stereochemistry, apimers are the distereomers which differs from each other at only one stereo center. Students, just try to memorize that, at only one stereo center. So glucose, galactose, mannose are apimers of each other, where glucose and mannose are differ in the position of hydroxyl group at C2 position, and whereas glucose and glucose differs from galactose at C4 position. Students, just discuss with the help of structure. Let's discuss where glucose and mannose are differ at C2 position. It's a carbon 2 and it differ at C2 position of their hydroxyl group, and where in galactose and glucose they are differ at C4 position. It's a carbon 4, students. So these are the apimers, means galactose and glucose are apimers and glucose and mannose are apimers. So the correct answer is galactose and glucose are the apimers. So hence the option A is the right answer. So next question, which is the vasoconstrictor? Options are, option A, PGE2, option B, PGF2, option C, TXA2, option D, PGI2. So which is the vasoconstrictor? So the correct answer is TXA2. Let's discuss with the help of explanation part. Here we have a table where it is mentioned in table, that is a PG and their receptors and what are the functions. Let's discuss individually that PGD2 and the receptor is DP. What are the functions? That is the platelet aggregation, vasodilation, relaxation of GIT, U and uterus, regulates sleep-wake cycle. And where PGF2, the receptor is FP and the functions are contractions of uterus and bronchi. And next is PGI2, receptor is IP, the functions are platelet aggregation, vasodilation, renin release and naturesis. And whereas TXA2, the receptor is TP and functions are platelet aggregation, vasoconstriction, which is asked in the question that which is the vasoconstriction. So TXA2 is the vasoconstrictor. And bronchoconstriction is also the function of TXA2. And talking about the PGE2 and the receptors are EP1, PEF2, EP2, EP3 and EP4. And they are having the function, these are having the functions of these, that bronchoconstriction, GIT mortality increase, colon cancer, bronchodilation, vasodilation, GIT relaxation, intestinal fluid secretion and many more. So this is all about this question. Moving on the next question, So the correct answer is C. And moving on, the next question is, a patient taking 10 ml arthropod suspension, that is 250 milligram per 5 ml QID, will receive how much arthromycin each day? So we have to give the quantity of the arthromycin that the patient will take and each day. And the options are option A, 2 gram, option B, 20 gram, option C, 4 gram, or option D, 40 gram. So a patient taking 10 ml of arthropod suspension, that is, which is 250 milligram per 5 ml QID, will receive how much arthromycin each day? So the quantity of arthromycin is 2 gram. So talking about with the help of explanation part, that 250 milligram into 2 into 4, that is 2000 milligram, so it converts into 2 gram. So the correct answer is 2 gram, hence it is the option A. So moving on, the next question, which of the following drug is implicated in the causation of osteomalacia of the bone? And the options are option A, phenytoin, option B, steroids, option C, heparin, option D, estrogen. So which of the following drug is implicated in the causation of osteomalacia of the bone is phenytoin. So phenytoin is the drug which is the causation of osteomalacia. So let's discuss how the phenytoin leads to the osteomalacia. So this is the main reason that phenytoin inhibits the hepatic production of 25 hydroxy vitamin D and also directly inhibit the bone mineralization and thus leads to the osteomalacia. So just try to note down that it inhibits the hepatic production of 25 hydroxy vitamin B and directly inhibit the bone mineralization, so leads to the osteomalacia. So where steroids and heparin results in osteoporosis, not osteomalacia. So important drugs causing osteomalacia are phenytoin, which is in the option and the correct answer, carbamazepine, valproate, phenobarbital, and biphosphates. So these are the drugs which are responsible for causing osteomalacia. So the correct answer is A, that is phenytoin. So moving on, the next question, a relation between vapor pressure and absolute temperature of liquid is given by, and the options are option A, Gibbs equation, option B, Clausius Clapeyron equation, option C, Arrhenius equation, and option D, Wentworth equation. So which is the relation between vapor pressure and absolute temperature of liquid is given by which scientist or which types of equation? So the correct answer is Clausius Clapeyron equation is given the relation between vapor pressure and absolute temperature. So let's discuss with the help of explanation or brief part, that is, here we have first is Gibbs equation, which tells us about the for determination of the enthalpy. Just try to memorize that Gibbs equation is related to the enthalpy, and where Clausius Clapeyron equation is used to make the relation between vapor pressure and temperature of liquid, and Arrhenius equation is for stability testing of formulation, and where Wontoff equation is used for the osmotic pressures. So these are all about the equations part. So the correct answer is Clausius Clapeyron equation. Hence the option B is the right answer. So moving on, the next question. In Gambier fluorescence test, green fluorescence in light petroleum layer is given by, student, this question is actually came in 2019 exam pharmacognosy section. So please keep note down these questions. Option A, pale catechu, option B, black catechu, option C, both A and B, and option D, terminalia arjuna. So which is the correct answer? So the correct answer is pale catechu. In Gambier fluorescence test, green fluorescence in light petroleum is given by pale catechu. So let's discuss that how pale catechu gives a green fluorescence in light petroleum layer. So Gambier fluorescence test. Here, in this test, a mixture of alcoholic extract of pale catechin and NaOH and petroleum ether is shaken and kept for some time. So what happened after this? So petroleum layer show green fluorescence where black catechu does not give. So pale catechu give green fluorescence and where black catechu does not give any fluorescence. So this is all about the Gambier fluorescent test. So the correct answer is pale catechu. That is option A is the right answer. Moving on the next question. Drug causing folate deficiency is, and the options are option A, INH, that is isoniazid, option B, methotrexate, option C, erythromycin, option D, cloxacillin. So which is the drug which is the responsible for the folate deficiency? So the correct answer is methotrexate is that drug which is responsible for the folate deficiency. So let's discuss in the explanation part that how many drugs which is the responsible for the folate deficiency. So it's an drug causing folate deficiency are it we are having a trick, that is pit map. So pit map is first is P for phenytoin, I for INH, that is isoniazid, T for trimethoprim, that is M for methotrexate, alcohol, and pyrimethamine, that is P I T, pit M A P, pit map. So I hope students this is very easy for you to learn. So the correct answer is methotrexate. So hence option B is the right answer. Moving on the next question. Assertion A is larocaprim is used as permeation enhancer. Reason are larocaprim is a furan derivative and act by fluidizing the lipid content of stratum corneum. So options are option A, that A and R are correct and R is the reason for A, and option B, A and R correct but R is not the reason for A. Option C, A is correct but R is wrong. Option D, A is wrong but R is correct. So what is the correct answer? So the correct answer is A is correct but R is wrong. So let's discuss that how is A is correct or but R is wrong. Let's discuss in explanation part that larocaprim is an azone derivative that acts by fluidizing the lipid content of stratum corneum, hence used as permeation enhancer. So the correct option is E, C is the right answer. So moving on the next question, that bridge and mirage series are options are option A, polyoxyethylene, polyoxypropylene copolymers, option B, polyoxyethylene monoalkyl ethers, option C, polyoxypropylene monoalkyl esters, option D, polyoxyethylene sorbitan esters of fatty acid. So bridge and mirage series are polyoxyethylene monoalkyl ethers. So the next question is dragon drop reagent is option A, potassium mercuric iodide, option B, potassium bismuth iodide, option C, potassium iodide, option D, picric acid. So which is the dragon drop reagent is? So the correct answer is potassium bismuth iodide is a dragon drop reagent, potassium bismuth iodide. So let's discuss in explanation part. So let's discuss individually that Wegener reagent is solution of iodine in potassium iodide and gives red precipitate. where drag and drop reagent is the solution of potassium bismuth iodide and gives reddish precipitate, where Mayer's reagent is potassium mercury iodide solution and gives cream color precipitate, and Hager's reagent, it is a solution of picric acid and gives yellow color. So it's all about this question. So the correct answer is drag and drop reagent. What it is? Solution of potassium bismuth iodide and gives reddish precipitate. So the option B is the right answer. So it's all about this video. Thank you.